Good evening, everyone. Any faint hope Geelong had that Corey Enright would make a miracle recovery for Friday's preliminary final is over. Enright was officially ruled out this morning. Meanwhile, a premiership-winning Hawk has declared the time has come to finally end the curse. Rob Waters reports.
The Cats have the Kennett curse going for them, but they also have a few issues. Chappie's been bumped, they don't like it, but are getting on with it. And Corey Enright, another club great, didn't train and has been ruled out.
He's come on pretty well this week, but we won't be playing him this week, though, unfortunately.
Tom Hawkins did train and is coming off his most encouraging effort for weeks, but he is still playing restricted. And smokescreen or not, the Cats say they are contemplating picking first gamer Shane Kirsten in a preliminary final.
I mean, these guys are pretty well conditioned around this place, and what they want to do is play in the senior team all the time, so I don't think that'll be a great ask.
Pop quiz, who was the last to do that? Well, Noel Lovell is the man. He debuted for the Magpies in the 1981 preliminary final when they beat Geelong. Prior to that, Len Thompson played his first game for Collingwood in the 1965 preliminary final. And the last Cat was Ted Toole back in 1938 against the Magpies. But the more likely scenario is Josh Caddy will come in and replace Chapman.
We're pretty sure that Josh will be fine.
Not many want a curse named after them. Ask Jeff. The last Hawthorn win against Geelong was also Shane Crawford's swan song, and he's not copping the curse.
Yeah, I've never really thought about that. I've always blamed Jeff, but I'm really confident they'll play really well on Friday night. We know Geelong have an exceptional record against them, but they couldn't be better placed.
Crawford is also keeping the faith, confident Buddy Franklin will ignore the extra millions on offer and remain a Hawk.
Definitely stay. I've been confident that he's going to stay all season.
Rob Waters, 10 Eyewitness News.